From the library homepage, we're going to start by going into the online and ebooks portal, and using the search box, go ahead and plug in a search term here that is a topic that you might consider for your research project. I've typed in video game addiction and I'm doing a search for that term. And one of the elements that is unique about databases as opposed to searching in a Google search engine or Yahoo is that the materials you find in an online database have been logged and looked at by human hands, and those human hands apply subject terms related to the article. So this article is linked to these terms. These are terms related to the subject. And the goal here in this video tutorial is to show you how you can use subject terms to help you broaden or refine a research topic. So step one in this exercise is to go into a database that you feel is most relevant to the research that you may do. So having reviewed the databases, I've decided that I'm going to use the multidisciplinary database Academic Search Complete. So I'm going to select that and hit OK. Once you are now in a single database as opposed to searching multiple databases, we're going to click up at the top on subject terms. And then you can choose either term begins with, term contains, or relevancy ranked. We're going to start just with term begins with. And I'm going to take a term like censorship, a broad subject, something that I'm interested in. And then you get a list, and you're going to find it's in alphabetical order. Over here where it has censorship, you'll see on the right it says explode. And what that means is that there's a lot more involved with the subject. So if we click on the term, similar to the Yahoo directory and the Google subject directory, this is really just a way to look at a term and look at related aspects of that term. So narrower aspects of censorship might include radio censorship or censorship of libraries. And then down here you also see related terms, freedom of information, freedom of speech, intellectual freedom. So I could take a subject like censorship and just by clicking and looking at some different terms, I've gone from regular censorship to potentially blacklisting of authors. Once you have a subject that you're interested in, you can actually click on this, and I can say, I think, and it's going to search for those subjects, and I can click search. And it's going to come up with a list of results related to blacklisting of authors and mass media censorship. And so just by playing around with some different articles, I can see what this subject has, what kind of resources are on this subject. You can play further with more subject terms. So I could take a term like violence, which is a big subject, and just add term contains, browse, and notice all of the different results that I get when I think about violence. So road rage, that might have not been the first thing that came to mind, but certainly there's a subject that is related to an issue going on in contemporary America, contemporary society. And then let's say you've got a subject. You can also play around with taking something like violence, road rage, and just do a search for it and seeing what kind of things come up. Notice here I even got a Google directory item that presents society issues, violence and abuse, and road rage being one of those issues, and then some additional sites that relate to that subject. So subject terms, play with them. Take some of the topics you've investigated thus far and see if you get some new
ideas on that particular subject.